Ask him, great sir, for CBSI Services. We're at Ad Week in New York today. Have a chance to talk with one of the speakers, Bruce Biegel of the Winterberry Group, and I just participated in a panel called Big M on Mobile, on the growth. And mobile is here. I liked one of your comments that no one leaves home without their mobile device. How do marketers prepare for mobile being first today?
I think you have to start to think through where that customer journey is. I think that mobile gives you a chance to speak to somebody when they're on the go and they're moving around. And for many, it's through an app, so it's an authenticated device, or it could be pushed through a text. So I think there's a lot of permission that goes with mobile, but it also restricts things that are not permissioned. So I think mobile gives a good balance for marketers.
And you talked about the challenge of authenticating customers, especially when they may have multiple devices. We all have tablets, mobile phones, laptops, and not to mention the Internet of Things coming up. How do you solve the problem of being able to identify that customer so you can seamlessly communicate with them?
I think if you're a large enterprise, the notion is, how do I build an identity graph that ties my first party data to data from either my partners or from third parties so that I can recognize? Recognition is the fundamental challenge to identity and to personalization. And you have to understand that there are multiple states. If I'm in an authenticated state and you have permission to know me, we have one level of interaction. If you've seen me before but I have not authenticated, there are things you're allowed to do and things that you may not be allowed to do. So understanding customer preference becomes key. And if you've never seen me before, it's the first time I walk through your store or the first time I see your ad, you have to treat me with more respect and more of a segment level, because I haven't given you permission to know me yet.
Very good. And you talked a little bit about the topic of artificial intelligence being widely used today. And you mentioned that tying systems together was a real challenge, integrating systems so that they talk to each other. What are some of the ways to do that, to be able to integrate artificial intelligence into an organization?
Yeah, I think artificial intelligence is still at the early stage. So while the technology is developing rapidly, being able to get the data that artificial intelligence needs to decision upon is where we have the first level of disconnect. So we need to be able to integrate it both in the PII, the personally identifiable information, and the non-PII states, and know when you're handing off between the two. So getting that data layer connected is probably one of the most important things to activate AI. Once you can start to do that, and you may take a small sample and just use AI for some applications, but once you do that, now you can start pushing out into more channels.
And you mentioned an interesting point between personalization and being personal. Personalization being larger segments, personal relationship being one-on-one. Why is it important to differentiate, and why would marketers have to be careful about not going too far on being personal?
I think it's a question of permissions. I know what permissions I'm willing to give at the one-to-one personal level. And if you give me the right value, I will allow you to use more of my data to have more of a direct one-to-one relationship. At the personalized level, it's, I want you to treat me with the right offer at the right time, but I don't necessarily want the creepy factor brought into that. So know me to a point, but then don't overstep your bounds.
Absolutely. And I'm thinking when your panel was discussing the issues today of mobile and artificial intelligence, is how does a small business compete? You have millions of small businesses. I know we talked a little bit about Amazon and the success it's had on providing convenience. But if you're working with smaller companies, what would be some of the keys that smaller companies trying to keep up should be thinking about?
I think it's leverage what you have. Don't try to do too much at once. You're not going to be Amazon. You're not going to have that level of data. Find partners, both to help you activate your marketing, but also to help you manage your data, because I think that you should do what's best, which is strategy, and think about how to interact, but you can't do it all yourself. And there's just not enough time in the day and not enough resources.
Very good. Bruce Biegel of the Winterberry Group, often speaking at the Direct Marketing Club of New York. We always appreciate that. And we'll see you out at the DMA conference in Las Vegas this week.
See you then. Thank you very much.
Pleasure. This is Ken Kratzer for CBSI Services in New York City at Adweek.